Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman invites investors to country, says no better place for them than India. Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad Sangma urges centre to consult stakeholders before introducing citizens' bill. Chirayu Lily Festival gets off to colourful start in Manipur. Union Minister says state centre joint move can promote tourism. A grateful state remembers R.G. Borua on his birth anniversary. And in Denmark Open, Sindhu advances with straight round win, Saina Nehwal crashes out. Good evening, viewers, and welcome to the Northeast News Bulletin. This is Ashutosh Sharma, now with the details. In news about Indian economy first, Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has said investors can find no better place in the world than India. Sitharaman said India has democratic environment that respects capitalists. She was speaking at an event hosted by the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, FICCI, in association with the US-India Strategic and Partnership Forum at the IMF headquarters in Washington. The minister said India is one of the fastest growing economies and has the best skilled manpower. She assured international investors that the government is continuously working to bring reforms. In order to boost overall consumption, the finance minister has requested all the public sector banks, together with their partners, non-banking financial companies, to reach out to small towns and villages and extend every kind of credit that they would want. Moving on to the Northeast now, in Meghalaya, Chief Minister Conrad K. Sangma on Wednesday said the central government should have consultations before introducing the Citizenship Amendment Bill in Parliament. Sangma said consultations must take place with the people, different political parties and non-governmental organizations as the issue affects all the people. Recalling his meeting with Union Home Minister Amit Shah, Sangma said the Home Minister had assured that consultations would take place and concerns of the people would be addressed.
Last time when we met the Honourable Home Minister in Guwahati, so we had a separate meeting with the Chief Ministers, and the Home Minister was very, very clear in his mind saying that he will talk to people, he will make visits, he will discuss, and he will try to ensure that.
In Tripura, taking a serious view of the defiant attitude of BRU refugee leaders towards the latest repatriation process, a four-member team of the Union Ministry of Home Affairs, MHA, headed by Special Secretary Dr. A.P. Maheshwari, held a meeting with representatives of the refugees and other stakeholders in Agartala on Wednesday to expedite the ongoing exercise. The MHA assured the BRU leaders of adequate security for repatriated refugees, while leaders of the Mizoram BRU Displaced People's Forum highlighted their stand on the repatriation process. The MHA officials reiterated the central government's commitment to early completion of repatriation.
In 2018, and we are honoring that. Government of Mizoram has made all the preparations for their going back. They made certain apprehensions about the security, so we have assured, okay, we'll ensure the security and the dignity of the human rights for every BRU, or every member of the BRU community. We are committed to their security. And number three, whatever developmental gaps or deficits are perceived, all the Government of India agencies will.
In Assam, campaigning has reached its peak for the bi-polls to be held in four assembly seats on the 21st of this month. Polling will be held at Sonari, Ratabari, Rangapara and Jania. Altogether, 20 candidates are in the fray. The ruling BJP and opposition Congress have fielded candidates in all the four seats. Bi-polls have been necessitated in these four seats, which fell vacant after the recent Lok Sabha elections. The Jania seat was represented by the Congress, while the rest three were won by the BJP in the 2016 assembly polls. Leaders of all the contesting parties are campaigning for their respective candidates. Taking part in the campaign today, Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal interacted with workers of Phulbari Tea Garden Falling in Rangapara constituency. He said all these years, Congress did nothing for the tea garden workers, while the BJP government has taken all possible steps to improve the quality of their life. Minister of State for Health Piyush Hazarika and Tejpur MP Pallab Lochan Das accompanied the Chief Minister.
কংগ্রেস দলটো 55 বছর রাজত্ব করলে দিল্লী তাহাঁতর সরকার আছিল আমার অসমতো সরকার আছিল কিন্তু 55 বছর থাকিও তেখেতসকলে কিন্তু আমার চাহ শ্রমিক রাইজর মনের বেদনা উপলব্ধি করব নয়।
In Manipur, Union Minister of State for Tourism and Culture Prahlad Singh Patel on Wednesday inaugurated the Shiroi Lily Festival 2019 at Shiroi Vangayan Ground of Ukhrul. Patel, along with State Chief Minister N. Biren Singh, inaugurated the Strength of Unity statue as a mark of opening the third edition of the four-day state festival. Speaking on the occasion, Patel said such cultural events reflect the beauty and treasure of India's culture. He said joint efforts of the state government and central government can only promote tourism and culture of a region to the level of people's expectations. Later, addressing the inaugural function of the two-day Inat Cultural Come Literary Meet 2019 of Manipur University of Culture at the auditorium of Manipur State Film Development Society, Patel assured that the center will take a key role in promoting the unique art and culture of Manipur to the world. In Tripura, Deputy Chief Minister Jishnu Debbarman, who is also holding the portfolio of power, has defended the government's decision of levying duties on power sale. He clarified that his initiative will not affect the poor as 52% of the consumers have been already exempted from the hike. He also announced that prepaid meters will soon be introduced for smart power supply in the state. Speaking at a media conference at the Civil Secretariat on Wednesday, he said the hike is meant for better revenue mobilization.
এবং যাদের বিশেষ করে ইস্যু নেই সেটা ইস্যু বাড়ানোর চেষ্টা করছে যদি অ্যাসেম্বলিতে খুব ভালোভাবে।
Still in Tripura, Tourism Minister Pranjit Sinha Roy today flagged off battery-operated vehicles and signed an agreement on behalf of Tripura Tourism Development Corporation, TTDC, with Narkel Kunja Tourism Cooperative Society. In his speech in the program in Agartala, Sinha Roy said if the state tourism sector is developed, Tripura can be economically self-reliant, which in turn will generate employment. In Manipur, just as the Ukhrul subdivision completes 100 years of its functioning, a centenary celebration was held by the district administration Ukhrul with Revenue Minister Karam Sham as the chief guest at the subdivisional office Ukhrul mini secretariat on Wednesday. In his speech, the minister said the Ukhrul subdivision was renamed to its present status of Ukhrul district after it was upgraded to East district on the 12th of November 1969. In Assam, people across the state today fondly remembered the contributions of Radha Govinda Borua on his birth anniversary. A program was organized on the occasion at Nehru Stadium, Guwahati. Speaking as the chief guest, Dispur MLA Atul Bora remembered how R.G. Borua had initiated several pioneering projects in the field of sports, including creation of infrastructure. He was a person ahead of his times, a visionary and an excellent administrator who had the courage to make his dreams come true, Bora added.
সিংহাসকলে গাঁওখনৰ নাম কৈঠালকুছি ৰাখিছিলে কষ্ট কৰি পেলাই শিয়াল বধই দুই এটা মাৰিছিলে কিন্তু আমাৰ ওচৰৰ গাঁৱৰ পঢ়া আৰু অকল লিখা কথা যদি ক'ৰবাত শিকিল দুটা বাক্য ইংৰাজী আৰু অসমীয়া তেতিয়াহ'লে এই তিনিখনে নগৰে তাৰমানে স্মাৰ্টফোন এতিয়া কাউৰে আগে বুলি গাঁও বাক্য মাত্ৰ মাতিছোঁ এই বাক্য এতিয়া আমাৰ।
In sports news, Manipur Governor Dr. Najma Heptullah inaugurated the National Sub Junior and Cadets Judo Championships 2019 at Kuman Lampak Indoor Stadium, Imphal on Wednesday. The championship is organized by Manipur Judo Association under the aegis of Judo Federation of India and will continue till October 19, 2019. Speaking on the occasion, the governor said Manipur is widely known as the powerhouse of sports in the country and has produced a number of national and international sportspersons in various disciplines, including the sport discipline of judo.
Successfully, two national championships in Manipur, one in 2008 and the other in 2013. And this is the third one, which more than 1,000 players from 30 states and union territories are participating in that championship.
In badminton, world champion PV Sindhu made an impressive start to her campaign at the Denmark Open, claiming a straight game win over Indonesia's Gregoria Mariska Tunjung in the women's single competition. Fifth seed Sindhu beat Gregoria 22-20, 21-18. The Olympic silver medalist will now face Korea's An Se-young next. On the other hand, earlier an ace Indian shuttler Saina Nehwal crashed out of the Denmark Badminton Open at Odense after losing to Japan's Sayaka Takahashi in women's singles. In Meghalaya, the National Health Mission on Wednesday organized a workshop at Negrims on the elimination of tuberculosis by the year 2025. Speaking on the occasion, Director of the Institute, Dr. D.M. Thapa, stressed the need for people to adopt healthy eating habits to protect themselves from tuberculosis. Dr. R. Sarin, Director of the National Institute of Tuberculosis and Respiratory Diseases, later spoke about the role of medical colleges in framing the strategies for effective treatment of the disease. Today is Karwa Chauth. Prem Mukhi, wife of Assam Governor Jagdish Mukhi, today organized a program at Raj Bhavan on the occasion in the presence of the governor himself. It is a ritual performed by women folk for the health and well-being of their husbands. In Tripura, acting on a tip-off, police apprehended Uttam Changma, impersonating as a BSF constable in Agartala on Wednesday. He was arrested on the charges of collecting money in return for jobs. And before we wind up the bulletin, a recap of the headlines. Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman invites investors to country, says no better place for them than India. Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad Sangma urges centre to consult stakeholders before introducing citizens' bill. Shiroi Lily Festival gets off to colourful start in Manipur. Union Minister says state centre joint move can promote tourism. A grateful state remembers R.G. Borua on his birth anniversary. And in Denmark Open, Sindhu advances with straight round win, Saina Nehwal crashes out. That brings us to the end of this evening's bulletin. Thank you for tuning in. Namaskar.